Yes, sir, we promised you a great
match. Gorgeous,
the maker of champions.
Andre, the champ.
WrestleMania.
Hulkamania is running wild.
Hulk Hogan, we got it for you, nigga. Definitely on the highest point of his career right now. Let's see who he brings over, ladies and gentlemen. First Raw draft pick coming up.
Who's it going to be?
Whoa!
Whoa! Whoa!
The world champion, Edge!
Oh, my God.
He's going to smack the Raw. Smack down the Raw.
He's taking the world championship with him.
Here comes the heavyweight champion right now.
Oh, my.
Wow.
This is huge. Oh, man.
Morrison gains the biggest advantage. Edge moving to Monday Night Raw. Just think about it. SmackDown has both the mid-card titles and now the Big Two titles and the whole entire WEDF for now are on Monday Night Raw.
You guessed it. Yep.
Strong words, Medge.
Undisputed. Undisputed. He's wanting to unify.
What the? Wait a minute!
Wait, no!
No!
Are you serious? And why does the referee have the Divas Championship? What the hell? What the hell? Like, that's for the spear!
Oh, shit! Spear!
Oh, my
spear!
God.
Spear!
It might be broken in half.
Yeah, no, wait a minute! Chris is fighting for back!
Oh.
The Instant Classic has so much to prove. He wants that world championship right now. He gets Edge in the ring. Edge is in the ring!
Oh, and so it's
Christian! We have a world championship match underway! Christian is just about to win the world championship! He's
going
to set up!
The kill switch and
get the world champion! Over, ladies and gentlemen, the world champion gonna be one!
We have a new world champion!
Christian is taking the World Heavyweight Championship back to SmackDown. We are coming off the heels of the WEDF draft, ladies and gentlemen, and we have a new World Heavyweight Champion on SmackDown. I am Osajax, joined here with my Platinum Age partner, Homer.
That's right, and tonight we're going to see the Hardcore Championship on the line. Abyss will take on the world's largest athlete.
The Big Show, and tonight we'll see a tag team match between the Hardy Boys and RVD and Dolph Ziggler.
This guy. We have Jack Swagger taking on a nerd. That's all you need to know. First, we have the World Heavyweight Champion coming out. No telling what he has to say after defeating his brother, Edge, on Raw, surprising everyone by cashing in his Money in the Bank briefcase.
Just to update you on what happened, ladies and gentlemen, just in case you missed the draft. Raw had earned a draft pick. Edge was drafted over to Raw. Claimed he was happy to be away from SmackDown. Claimed he wanted to become the undisputed champion. Only for Christian to exercise his rights as the SmackDown Money in the Bank holder. Cashing in right then and there for a world championship match. And just as you see, ladies and gentlemen, that world heavyweight championship around his waist confirms it. the instant classic of the WEDF has realized his dream.
Yeah, that's absolutely correct. I gotta say, though, I'm glad you mentioned you went through all that, but if you missed the last episode of WEDF, if you missed the Raw, if you missed the draft, get your ass back up there and watch it, because you have missed a lot, and you will be lost if you do not stay with this stuff.
That is correct. You know what's probably the great thing about it?
What's
it's
that?
The only place you're ever going to see it, since WWE's like, no, we don't want to do this.
That's absolutely correct.
Strong words from the instant classic.
Finally fulfilling his dream.
Wait a minute, hold on now. Wow. One of SmackDown's newest draft picks, Kurt Angle.
No surprises here. I'm sure he's here to claim his stake in the World Heavyweight Championship picture.
After his big win at WrestleMania and his victory over Kofi Kingston on the last Raw, Angle has a right to claim claim a stake on the World Championship.
Angle telling Christian not to get comfortable with that title.
As you can see, things are not getting easy for Christian right away. Kurt Angle is no regular man. Whoa, wait a minute!
Oh, shit.
Things are getting even more intense. Now here comes Goldberg out to answer a challenge. He just got done beating CM Punk on the last Raw. And he, after the match of the year he had with Sheamus, who's to say that he doesn't have a claim on the World Championship, too? I think a lot of these guys in the ring do.
What surprised me about Goldberg is his attack on Cena during the WEDF Championship match on Raw.
We still need a few answers to that. Speaking of which, John Cena has been drafted to SmackDown. We'll probably see him come out here, if I had to guess.
Goldberg saying that he'll do anything to get to that championship gold.
Well,
speaking of Cena,
speak of the devil. John Cena coming out, the former WEDF champion, failed to defeat The Rock once again in the main event of the last WEDF Raw. But now things are getting really interesting.
You must remember, though, that was no thanks to Goldberg's spear at the very end of that match.
That's very true. Let's see what's up. Well, it's just like Frank Dog said. Goldberg said Cena is next.
Seems like we have a lot of people here who think that they should be the next World Heavyweight Champion. If I were Christian, I'd be nervous right now.
Correction. That's Cat 1, Cena. That is Cat 1.
That is Cat 1, but we won't talk about that now.
Oh, wait a minute!
Oh, shit!
Things are getting personal between John Cena and Goldberg. A scuffle has broken out in the middle of the ring, and now Kurt Angle and the World Champion are getting involved. Trying to restrain these men.
Trying to find some... Wait, what the fuck?
What?
Well, here's our general manager, Teddy Long, here to bring some order to this.
Danny Jackpot randomly getting involved out of nowhere. Now we will see, hopefully, a calm on the situation. Teddy Long needs to bring some justice here.
He's right. This is not a way to kick off the greatest show in WEDF.
That's correct. Teddy Long getting right to business. Oh!
Oh, wow.
Aha! I like this. I like this.
And that is why Teddy Long is the general manager of SmackDown. He He knows how to get things done, and tonight we're going to see a fatal, an elimination four-way match.
SmackDown getting started right away. Kurt Angle, Danny Jackpot, John Cena, and Goldberg in a four-way to determine who will face Christian next week for the World Championship. But right now, ladies and gentlemen, we're going to get started with our first match of the night. The Monster Abyss, undefeated, defends the Hardcore Championship against the world's largest athlete, The Big Show.
Abyss, obviously on this huge roll, has not lost a single match in his career yet, but the one person to be the closest of anybody is the guy he's facing tonight. So the question is, are we going to crown a new Hardcore Champion?
Abyss, though, ladies and gentlemen, he did defeat the Big Show, last eliminated Big Show at the Monsters Ball to capture that Hardcore Championship. And there you hear Kane's music. If you forget what happened, Abyss choke slammed Kane right through the center of the ring, just as Kane had defeated Batista in a match to gain a draft pick for SmackDown. Now all three of the Brothers of Destruction are back on the same brand as it was before.
Not just that, but I want to bring to everyone's attention the man who has come out to Abyss's side. That is Paul Bearer, who is apparently taking a vested interest in Abyss, of all people.
This is supposedly one of the Brothers of Destruction, but right now, here comes the Big Show.
Big Show, the world's largest athlete, stands over 7 feet tall, 500 pounds. This guy is a monstrosity. The question is he too much for Abyss to take on?
One thing Abyss certainly has to watch out for when he's facing the Big Show is that deadly right-hand hook. It reminds me so much of Michael Tarver's kill shot that it's not even funny.
That knockout punch will change everything about a match. You could be on a roll, and that knockout punch will take you from 60 to 0 in no time.
No doubt about it. No one, rarely if anyone, has gotten up from the knockout punch that the Big Show delivers.
I gotta say, I'm curious as to why the Big Show is wearing white. I mean, white is, of course, the color of the Platinum Age, but
White and gold.
White and gold, of course, but the Big Show, of course, has no invitation into the Platinum Age.
Collar and elbow tie-up, Big Show and Abyss getting right in the ring. Big Show with a big elbow to Abyss, and now just punching away at him. Challenger surprisingly in control, and ladies and gentlemen, this is at least half a ton of destruction just sitting in the ring right now.
Let's just hope they don't try anything on the top rope. We have seen Big Show do two sunset flips, so anything's possible.
Yes, we also don't need a reminder of how awesome that superplex was that Brock Lesnar did to Big Show in the past.
Wow, a beautiful DDT by the Big Show.
Well, he is the world's largest athlete for a reason. Wait a minute, Big Show! Choke slam!
Manhandling the Hardcore Champion.
This could be over right away. Here comes up. No!
No.
Surprisingly, Abyss gets the shoulder up. Not even two!
Oh, and Paul Bearer throws in a steel chair. Finally bringing the Hardcore into this Hardcore Championship match.
Bringing it right away. Abyss got hold of that chair! Just smacking right into the world's largest athlete.
Oh. Got hit in the side of the face and right into the forehead.
Abyss bringing it now to the Big Show. And I gotta say, if there's anyone who could possibly stop Abyss and end his undefeated streak, who would you think would have the best chance of doing it right now if Big Show can't do it tonight?
If Big Show can't do it? If Big Show can't do it, I gotta look at... I gotta go into the family. I gotta go with The Undertaker. The Undertaker has a lot of reasons to want to defeat him, and he's got all the resources.
But remember, Undertaker could not stop Abyss. Kane has failed to stop Abyss. Everyone Abyss has come into contact with couldn't stop him. Five monsters in the same ring as Abyss could not stop him at WrestleMania. This Hardcore Championship match will continue after this break, ladies and gentlemen. Hardcore Championship match between the Monster Abyss and the world's largest athlete, The Big Show, continuing right now, ladies and gentlemen.
Both of these men are on par in terms of their ability in the mat in this match. There isn't a clear advantage of who's going to win this.
Luthes pressed by Abyss right there. Just, I gotta agree with you, Matt. It's been back and forth between both of these monsters, but I don't know. I honestly don't know just how much of a challenge Abyss is really, I mean, Big Show is really gonna bring to Abyss.
Well, I'd say that Abyss is finally doing something about this match. Wait, Paul Bearer, what is he?
This is a big disadvantage for Big Show right now. This is strength in numbers. Even though Paul Bearer, you really don't expect him to do too much, and there you go.
But there he is. He's the distraction that Abyss needs. Abyss can take advantage of that one second distraction and capitalize on it like he's doing right now.
Getting right back in the game, taking a big advantage over the Big Show.
Oh, shit. He just lifted the Big Show off of his feet. 500 pounds of monstrosity and weight.
Oh, man.
What's that?
Tossed right into those steel steps. That is not pretty. Oh, wait a minute. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Shock treatment. The shock treatment. This is not good. We all know what's coming next.
Oh,
the black hole slam.
This has to be it.
Here's the cover. One, two, three.
And nobody can stop the monster. This is just insane. I don't know what to say right now. I mean, not even the Big Show.
Look at that double arm choke slam into the steel steps. That really sealed the Big Show's fate, because right from there, it was the shock treatment. And then, as you're going to see right, or not. Oh, wait, yeah, you are.
Yeah, we will see right here.
The black hole slam that sealed it, that sealed the deal and made Abyss retain the Hardcore Championship. I got to say, though, that wasn't a little due part to Paul Bearer, but Abyss goes to prove to us all that he's not just a hunk of meat and muscle. He has a brain in there, and he was thinking when he had Paul Bearer come out with him.
Not just that, but the awareness of those ring steps and everything. I mean, that was a decisive win by the Monster Abyss, and he deserves to be the Hardcore Champion.
I don't know if anyone will get to the Hardcore Championship now. Oh, wait a minute. Paul Bearer has a microphone. That's correct. Undertaker did bury Paul Bearer in a casket of cement. Wait a minute. Here we go.
Paul Bearer making a beeline out of that ring.
He knows of the Undertaker's power better than anyone else, intimidated by the Demon of Death Valley.
Now the Undertaker grabbing a mic. The lies. The Undertaker's calling out James Mitchell.
Father James Mitchell. We've all seen him with Abyss sometime before, and I see that Undertaker is now out for revenge once again.
Well, up next, we have a tag team match. The Hardy Boys reunite to take on Dolph Ziggler and Rob Van Dam.
There's also a special stipulation in this match. If the Hardys win, Matt Hardy will get a chance at Jeff Hardy's Intercontinental Championship, I believe, on the next edition of SmackDown. However, if Rob Van Dam and Dolph Ziggler win here tonight, then it will be a triple threat match between Rob Van Dam, Dolph Ziggler, and Jeff Hardy for the Intercontinental Championship.
That's correct. And I gotta say, if you're Jeff Hardy in this match, you've gotta have the one thing you have to make sure you do is to not take your mind off of this match tonight. Because if he tries to think about next week and who he defends his title against, that could end up costing him the match.
As they say, keep your friends close and your enemies closer. Jeff Hardy has got to have eyes in the back of his head when he teams with his brother Matt here tonight.
You have a point there, but I think that the Hardys, they've been friends for forever. They've been since birth, and they've been teaming for over a decade together. I don't see Matt betraying his brother for a championship like that.
You still got to remember, though.
Go ahead.
You still got to remember, though, Jeff Hardy, this is for a big chance at a championship. Matt Hardy, all he has to do is work with Jeff, and then next week, Jeff is all his.
That's correct. But coming down to the ring right now, my favorite person in this match, you all know it, that Dolph Ziggler is one of my favorite competitors.
He's one of my favorite, too. PA prime talent right there. We have been in talks with Dolph Ziggler. We have shown interest in adding the great man from Kent State with born the deadly...
Born and raised in Cleveland, Ohio, of course, amateur wrestler at Kent State. And here's his tag team partner, the former Continental Champion, Rob Van Dam.
Here's the interesting thing about Rob Van Dam and Dolph Ziggler teaming up here tonight. This seems like a one-time reunion of the 420 Society here tonight. So you got to think, Rob Van Dam and Dolph Ziggler have definitely got to be on the same page here tonight.
Not only that, but I mean, you look at one of the two people that they're facing off against, and that's another former member of the 420 Society.
The man who betrayed the 420 Society in the end, regardless of an ending or not.
The question is, do those guys even remember after all the weed they smoked? I mean, this match starts off with Matt Hardy and Dolph Ziggler.
Hardy gained a huge win against, who was it? I don't even remember. But in any case, Matt Hardy has been proven to be the guy who, as many times as he tries to get a world championship, get any kind of championship, get any kind of big success to his name, he can never pull it
off. I think I know where you were going with that, and I think you were trying to figure out his opponent on Raw. He actually defeated Rob Van Dam to bring his brother to SmackDown.
That is correct. I forgot about that. Thank you there, man.
Wait, Jeff gets the... Oh, what is this?
This is Poetry in Motion. Poetry in Motion.
Jeff and Matt showing that experience. But Jeff,
extreme
too close
experience.
To the ropes.
Here's a little known fun fact for you people out there who don't know this. Jeff and Matt Hardy actually owned a wrestling federation together called Omega.
That's correct.
So these brothers definitely have a lot of history.
They have a lot of history in the ring together. They have a lot of experience to both together and against each other. But one thing is for certain, that these two know their way around the wrestling ring.
Not sure what Jeff Hardy was going for there, but this has allowed Dolph Ziggler to get back in control long enough to tag in Rob Van Dam.
I think that's what these two competitors have to do. They have to capitalize on mistakes. I think that's where matches are won and lost, is where whoever can capitalize the most on the little mistakes that are made in a match.
That is correct. Any small mistake you make can become your worst nightmare. We've seen that happen millions of times with guys like Shelton Benjamin in matches against our current world champion Christian. Where we could see it happen now. We've seen it everywhere, actually.
That's right. And
I just thought about this. We even saw it with CJ Wizard. He didn't think that we were going to make our impact on DCO. And guess where he's at now? Unemployed.
I don't even know who you're talking about. But Matt Hardy with the cover on Rob Van Dam.
You should know what I'm talking about. We're talking about capitalizing on opportunities. And, well, we capitalized on our opportunity to make an impact. Where are we now? We're still in the WEDF. Where is CJ Wizard? Unemployed.
That's right. And we still haven't made our official decision yet.
We are going to make our official decision tonight, though. Hint, hint.
That is true. I mean, I've heard rumors about us coming here to SmackDown. I mean, we do have Zack Starr. We have Vicky Guerrero.
We have everything we want. This is our home away from home, basically.
It pretty much is, yeah. I mean, we have family here now.
Back to the mats. Jeff Hardy with a running drop kick on the Rob Van Dam and going into that quick cover.
I will say that ever since Rob Van Dam was tagged in, the Hardys have done everything they can to keep the match on their end of the ring, and they've been using that tag team mentality of tagging, of quick tags, to really isolate Rob Van Dam and to keep the match in their favor. But as we said, capitalizing on the mistakes, Jeff Hardy made a big mistake, accidentally taking out the ref, and now Rob Van Dam is able to tag his tag team partner in, Dolph Ziggler.
I gotta say, it looks like Rob Van Dam has become so much of a weak link right now. The Hardys just seem to be too much of a challenge for the former 420 Society leader. Here comes Ziggler with the cover. One, and Matt Hardy breaks up the count right away. This is what you need to rely on in quick tag team wrestling. Matt Hardy was right there to stop the count before anything got bad.
That's where you have to trust your tag team partner in everything that you do, including breaking up those moments where you may not be able to get yourself out of those situations. Right now, Dolph Ziggler is showing some impressive... trying to get that momentum. Very, very back and forth right now. It's hard to call the action, and there's a clothesline by Jeff.
Some personal interest in this match as well. Remember, Jeff Hardy also defeated Dolph Ziggler to bring him to SmackDown.
That's right. This match is just full of history between these four men.
Also, another interesting thing to point out, three of the four of these men in this match are former world champions in their own right.
That's right. Dolph Ziggler may be the least experienced in this match, but he is definitely not the worst, per se. He definitely has the ability. He's that young talent that the Platinum Age. We love to talk. I mean, that's something that we thrive on, is being young, hot talent. And Dolph Ziggler fits that. I mean, if he makes a decision to come to us, then that's even better for us.
I mean, let me put it to you this way. Dolph Ziggler may not have the big names as being a world champion in WWE, WEDF, or TNA, or ECW, or any of that. But the main thing that matters for Dolph Ziggler is that he is not inexperienced. He knows exactly what he is doing when he gets in that ring. He is not a one-trick pony. He's not a dumb guy. He doesn't botch. He's basically one of the guys who will drive the future of this business. And that is what the Platinum Age is all about, the future of this business.
That's right. I gotta say, Rob Van Dam is showing some impressive work right now. He's got him, Matt Hardy in a cover. Jeff Hardy, I think, breaking that up just in the nick of time.
That is correct. He just did. Rob Van Dam with a quick tag to Dolph Ziggler. Here we go. Drop toe hold to an elbow drop. Very nice teamwork from the two members of the former 420 Society, showing that they're still together.
Knocking Jeff Hardy off of the apron. Quick punches and kicks.
I think this is also a big mistake that the Hardys have also been making as I've been observing this match. Both Jeff Hardy and Matt Hardy have been focusing too much on the 420 Society members, or former 420 Society members, while they were still up. And, well, basically, let's put it like this. Say Rob Van Dam is the illegal partner. Hardy would attack him, and Ziggler would fire back since he was legal and take advantage of the distraction.
Oh, what a huge German suplex.
Ladies and gentlemen, who will face Jeff Hardy on the next SmackDown? Find out after this.
Shit, what was that?
Very nice.
I am now recording and whatnot.
And whatnot. Before I count down, my name is Alberto Del Rio.
But you already knew that.
Exactly. Match continues between Ziggler and RVD against the Hardys. Winner of this tag match will go on to face Jeff Hardy in that ring you see right there for the Intercontinental Championship.
Dolph Ziggler showing some impressive work.
It's just like we promoted. Wait.
There's the zigzag. Could that be it?
Matt's No, he's not. He's getting back down, and here comes the cover.
There's the cover. This could be it.
One, two, three.
And Ziggler and RVD will be facing Jeff Hardy in a triple threat match for the Intercontinental Championship. Let's look at a replay of what we saw in this match.
Pretty good match, back and forth between both teams, and both members, they focused a lot on the illegal members, but it was crucial teamwork from the 420 Society, them focusing on the Hardys all throughout, legal and illegal, keeping that perfect balance, which allowed Dolph Ziggler to hit the zigzag on the Intercontinental Champion.
I will say that the point that I made before is exactly what happened in this match, which was Dolph Ziggler capitalized on the mistakes, which allowed him and Rob Van Dam to win this match and move on for a shot at the very prestigious Intercontinental Championship.
Now keep in mind, Ziggler just pinned the Intercontinental Champion. This could be a sign of the future of what's to come for next week.
That's right. If he does it again next week, we will be crowning a new Intercontinental Championship. Or an Intercontinental Champion. I'm sorry. I had a Scott Steiner moment.
I believe we will be going into text mode, so don't worry about that.
That's right. We're just going to go into it. Right, a sexy cougar.
Shut up, Matt. You're supposed to be in text mode.
Fuck you.
No. We have 20 valets for that.
Alright. Now, moving over to getting a talking mode. As you can see, we're the very sexy platinum age we're coming out right now.
And we are also going to pull shades of DCO Episode 7 and commentate our own match here.
We would find somebody to commentate our match, but nobody would do us justice like we can.
Well, there technically is two people, but they're not here. And they are Chet Lemon and Black Snow.
Well, of course, two of the greatest in the game.
Zach Starr getting in the ring, and I am, and Meow Meow's falling right behind.
Right. And look at us. We are just a well-oiled machine. We will only get stronger as the days go by.
Yes, we will. Rocking that white and gold. And before we go along somewhere, I gotta say thank you for bringing us in the WEDF in the first place, Matt.
You know, I mean, I did what I had to do. Let's let our boy talk.
Hell yeah, I like the sound of that.
Fine, you know, I ain't gonna complain about him winning that. It's a damn shame.
That's right.
Look, I'll admit I was one of those people too.
Yes, but Zach Starr has now proven himself to be straight and great. Oh yeah.
That's right. I think that's Platinum Mage's motto, straight and great.
Yes. Gaining new mottos and valets every day. I think I'm going to have to go into text mode here a little bit.
All right, do your thing. Ooh, I love the sound of that.
Really?
Tech
this is our challenge? This is our challenge. I just said we were going to become tag team champions, and they throw us two people who don't even deserve to lace our boots.
I mean, look, I'm not happy about this either, but let's just do what we had to do. You know, we win this match, and people will just know. People will just confirm what they already knew, which is that we're great.
By the way, wasn't it Shad's time? So much for that.
Well, I mean, his time was kind of up, so...
His time was up when R-Truth came out with a new great theme.
That's true. That was about time for me to get buck.
About time for me to get crunk.
About time for me to step it up.
Knuckle up.
Let's blow the roof off. Anyway, here's our quote-unquote opponents.
Supposedly, they're a warm-up.
I mean, I don't mean to sound
racist. The real
racist.
Opponents are your moms.
I don't mean to sound racist, but we're about to have a hate crime situation.
Oh, yeah, especially considering that I was pretty much a racist back in XWA. Thank you, Homer.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, use that. There's my boy.
And I look like John Morrison. Now I don't, but still.
Motherfucker just clipped me.
Hey, I'm not even trying right now. I oversold that drop kick, man. There's no way I could do a backflip like that.
Right,
I'm overselling him right now. Okay, I'm gonna try a little bit.
Yeah, do something.
What? Okay.
Alright, well, let's...
Not even trying. I'm just not gonna say anything. Not even trying. No.
Hey, you should try a little bit.
Why?
Look.
I mean, if I tried a lot right now, then we'd have a complete squash match, and this would already be over.
Here comes light-skinned, bigger black guy. Got the pin from shorter, darker black guy.
Oh, what's the difference? They're just both wearing they're shirtless and they're wearing jeans and some out-of-date Uggs.
Hold on, fuck that. Bow. You're not getting the pin like that.
No, I seriously wasn't gonna kick out.
Well, that's
just because I felt like it.
No, I know you were gonna kick out. That's why I had to run in there, making things difficult. See, dude, there you go. Now let me in here. Making me nervous.
Yeah, see, I'm in a not-trying mood. I don't feel the need to try against these guys.
Look, that's fine, I want to... I don't know what the fuck that was. Look, I want to kick some ass, so let me get in here and... Bop!
Now, why do you want to kick some ass?
Because, I really don't have an answer for that, but...
Yeah, you do. It's called... I don't know.
Fuck. I didn't expect taller, lighter-skinned black guy to... Oh, shit. I'm in their corner now.
Are you trying?
I mean, a little bit. I mean, you saw that move. It didn't take much. Fuck.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we just gotta say we're not trying right now. And if we did try, then this would be like a 30-second squash and nobody would still be talking about this.
Did you see that? He tried to hit me.
He grabbed the ref. And you know why he grabbed the ref? Because he thought he was a prisoner.
Fuck. My face. My beautiful face.
Black and white bars. Remove the white, and that's what Shad's going to see as soon as this match is over. Black bars, because he's going to prison.
Oh, shit.
Rape crime.
Oh, no. Another. Fuck.
That generic tag team move that everybody... Outdated dance from 7 years ago.
2007 called it. Wants its dance back.
Shake that Laffy Taffy while we're at it.
No, he'll do the Soulja Boy next.
Oh my god. Then he'll do the R-Truth dance, which takes like 2 minutes.
There we go. I kicked out at two. I let him think he was... Hey, watch this. Pow! And... Fuck. Oh, look at this.
Oh shit. Big man going to the top.
That's right. Because that's the only place that fits me as the top. Did you like that? Did you expect me to do something like that?
Actually, yes.
Well, I know you did, because you're great.
Of course I am. Now tag me in.
All right, here you go. All right, now watch this.
What fat man is going to be able to do this?
Whee! Spin cycle, motherfucker. You better wash some jeans.
The only fat man capable of doing this is El Jefe.
That was a nice belly to black suplex.
Belly to black, of course. Suplex!
Oh shit.
Hey, ref, you gotta restrict this man. He poked me in the eye.
Oh, I think he's got a weapon hiding in his pocket, in his pants.
Typical black guy.
Oh, lighter, taller, black skin, light skin, black eye. Oh shit, that was actually kind of good. That was kind of cool. You need to make sure that doesn't fuck.
Michael Tarver did it better.
Michael Tarver does everything better.
Yeah, that's true. Lariat. John Breschel, Lariat, and the suspect did that better, admittedly. Oh, wait, nope. Nope. You gonna hit me with that? I'll hit you with a belly to belly. I'm Kurt Angle, bitch. And now I'm Wade Barrett to an extent.
Oh, look at that.
This here, what you call domination.
Make him feel it.
Thumb to the eye again, ref. Restrict him. Lighter, taller, dark skin guy. And oh, nope.
Oh, mm-mm. That was beautiful.
Thank you.
Now let me in here. You know what? I'm just going to end this right now. We've had enough fun.
Yeah.
Wow.
Let's try. They're dead. They're dead. See, look at Zack Starr. He's being like a cheerleader. I think I'm going to try to find some pom-poms for him. Wait, I'm back in? God damn it.
Well, I mean, look, we're just going to have some...
Flames of Difference.
Yes, the Flames of Difference is what we're about.
Goodbye, ladies and gentlemen. I am Wade Barrett, and I'm here to talk to you today about the Flames of Difference.
I gotta say, that was some nice airtime. I didn't think you were gonna hit him.
I learned that from NBA Jam, son.
Oh.
Get Air Jordan on.
Drop him on his neck.
Am I gonna end it? Nah.
Well, you can end it when you want.
Yeah, go for it. After I do that. And that. Are we tight? Yeah, we are.
Alright, there you go. Now.
Now this is how you do a lariat.
Whee! Pow! Alright, now I'm gonna end it. Is that good with you?
Yep, that's fine with me. Let me go find the pom-poms for Zachy.
Boom.
And here we go.
This is for you, Tarver. Pow! There's the kill
shot. And that is the show killer.
That's right. Alright.
One, two, and Crime Time goes back to prison. Well, they are Crime Time after all, right?
That's right, we just convicted their asses. Alright, let's take a look at that beautiful replay. Why would you show this? Oh, because I kicked out because I'm great.
Where are our good moments? Okay, there's a good moment.
And then here's... Look, I'm sorry if I'm taking over this replay, but...
Eh, you wanted to get the win anyway. I was just like, hi, I'm Osha Jax.
And then here we go, watch this.
Kill Bam. Shot.
Black eye for a black man.
Yes.
One, two. It never gets old.
It never gets old.
Not for celebrate.
With Zack Starr.
Right. You hear those boos? They aren't really saying boo, they're saying boo words.
I thought they were saying boobs.
That's right. Zach Starr,
speaking of which,
Zach Starr for celebrating with us because, well, he's great.
Zach Starr is great. He needs pom-poms next time. And be dressed in a skirt. And look, we're back in our regular attire. Yeah.
Oh my god, look at that. It's the hottest woman in professional wrestling.
She is so hot.
Her voice is sexy too.
She is voluptuous.
Oh man.
Ada's gonna hate.
Oh shit, I think she's gonna say something.
Oh my god.
She speaks the truth too. She's smart and sexy.
And powerful.
That's right. Oh, well, there you go.
Yay! And we will be right back after this sexy message.
Look, I might have to go have a moment with Vicky, if you don't mind.
We all will. We all will.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. And while this nerd comes out, I want to take the time to apologize to the NAACP for the words and actions that you just witnessed. I love
and Reverend people. Jesse Jackson.
That's right. I'm actually half black myself. We're just having a little fun with Prime Time. But right now, we're going to our next match. And you know what? Just say something. I need a moment.
This guy. This is a new signee to the WEDF, ladies and gentlemen. This is Daniel Bryan. Been wrestling on the indies for 10 years, finally making his big debut.
He's a nerd.
As a part of the SmackDown roster now. And as you can see, Homer is getting into Michael Cole mode here.
He's a fucking nerd. This guy doesn't own a television. What the fuck is he doing in his spare time?
Well, Homer is a fellow coal miner himself. He is. Daniel Bryan is making his debut tonight here against former United States champion Jack America. Excuse me, Swagger.
This guy is a true American. Two-time University of Oklahoma.
All American. American.
I could speak about this guy all day. He is amazing in every way. A true amateur wrestling superstar. His talent exceeds all expectations.
There's some sort of untapped potential in Jack Swagger that we certainly haven't seen yet.
Well, this is his chance. I mean, look at this guy. This guy is shorter than the referee.
This happened before.
This guy looks like Hornswoggle in Burgundy.
Well, Daniel Bryan, ladies and gentlemen, he has been regarded by many fans who my friend Homer here considers ROH bots as one of the, if not the exact, best technical wrestler in the world, referred to as the American Dragon by many fans. And I gotta say, I have no problem personally with Daniel Bryan, but I mean, I sort of agree with Homer about everything that he said right now.
Look, this guy claims to be a vegan. Do you know what that means? Look, alright, I'll explain this to you. A vegetarian doesn't eat meat, and those people are pussies. But this guy goes even farther to say, I won't eat animal products. He doesn't even... What kind of grown man doesn't eat cheese?
Well, if you don't eat meat, then you're straight, because if one of us ever ate meat, we'd be called Zack Starr. Before he got cool. I mean, am I right?
I just hope that Swagger puts this guy in his place. And right now, there we go. Yes. Impressive looking German suplex by the All-American American.
I mean, no disrespect to you, but Daniel Bryan is a hell of a technical wrestler.
How dare he disrespect CM Punk and that other Japanese dude by doing this?
I believe his name was it Kenta? I'm not sure.
Who gives a fuck? But CM Punk should be feel disrespected by that action right now. There you go. Teach him a lesson, Jack Swagger.
Well, then again, CM Punk did come from the same place that this guy did come from.
But the difference is CM Punk is better than this guy. CM Punk is amazing, and we all know that. But this guy.
Oh yeah,
nerd.
Plus CM Punk's straight edge. So I'm not gonna argue that too much.
This guy is a nerd and a tool and a loser, and that will be proven tonight.
Well then, I didn't know Homer just suddenly transformed into Michael Cole, but regardless, Daniel Bryan has certainly.
What a gut-wrench suplex by the Jack Swagger. There's the cover. This should be it. One, two, and
Daniel Bryan barely getting his shoulder up. Jack Swagger going right on the attack. And I gotta say, both of these men, Swagger and Bryan, both included, have a lot of things to prove. Swagger is probably looking to jump up into the world title picture after a successful United States Championship run, for the most part.
very smart move by Swagger, trying to wear down the arms of... How the hell does he do that? That guy is like 4 feet tall.
Well, you gotta remember, Homer, Daniel Bryan is experienced at submission wrestling. One thing that Swagger has to look out for when he faces Daniel Bryan is that lapel lock.
I think something that Daniel Bryan should look for is knees to the face. There's a cover.
Jack Swagger trying to do everything he can to keep this young man down. And there you go, Daniel Bryan working on those legs again. Locking in that heel hold and pulling back with everything he's got right now. And I gotta say, Daniel Bryan, love or hate the guy, there is no denying that this man is a wonderful technical wrestler. The talent is there. The it factor, the mic skills, they may not be, but there is no denying that when you face Daniel Bryan in that wrestling ring, you are going to have your hands full. And that's exactly what Swagger is finding out here tonight. But Swagger is not going to go down easy.
Look, both of these men. The reason why you and I and the Platinum Age are rising stars in this company is because we have the total package. We are great in the ring. We proved that earlier. And we are good on the mic. We've been great on the mic for a while. But this guy is boring. This guy's boring me. This is boring. I am bored to tears every time this 4 foot midget vegan nerd gets in the ring.
He's like, what, like 160 pounds maybe? I don't know exactly.
He weighs less than my right leg.
Okay. Anyway, Daniel Bryan just put in the ankle. Oh, wait a minute. Here we go. Daniel Bryan has got it in. The lapel lock.
You have to get out of this. Swagger, you have to find a way out.
The lapel lock is in, and, well, there it is. Daniel Bryan debuts in style, getting a big, big win via submission.
I'm sorry, I refuse to watch this replay in this celebration, so I'm gonna go take a walk, all right?
You do that, man, you do that. Well, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. There you see Daniel Bryan applying that ankle lock. Very interesting, since Swagger's known for that ankle lock a little bit. And there you see the lapel lock ending the match. Daniel Bryan is a great technical wrestler. Don't listen to everything Homer tells you for granted. He has his own opinion. I have mine. Daniel Bryan, nonetheless, makes a great debut here tonight, defeating a former United States champion in WEDF in just his debut. A great start for a man like Daniel Bryan. Let's hope he has a great career. And what the?
And pow! Gotcha, bitch. I told you this was going to end for you. Well, for you. You think next time you celebrate on my show. Right.
Well, I do have to agree.
All right. Now, we got... Let's try to move on from that. We got Lashley being interviewed. All right.
Take a deep breath real quick for me, Matt, because I think I'm going to need to, because I don't know how to react to that attack, to be honest with you.
Look, we don't have to agree on everything.
I'm not saying I agree or disagree. I'm just saying, you know, I'll stay neutral, but hey, if he does something against you, I've definitely got your back, man. Don't worry about it.
Here's what I'll say. This is a great way to transition. Right now we're going to see two of WEDF's newest superstars face off against each other for a chance for momentum. Right now we're seeing Drew McIntyre, Scotland's import, a very impressive superstar in my eyes.
A man that people have called the Chosen One at time to time, a very controversial name at that, to be called with the story this man has had. But tonight, he is making his debut in WEDF, brought in the WEDF just before the draft, along with other guys like Alberto Del Rio, Vance Archer, Daniel Bryan, who else?
The man that Drew McIntyre will face tonight, which is Luke Gallows, I believe, was here before, but...
Yes, he was. That is correct. Luke Gallows was
formerly
here
Festus,
before.
But I think that... Luke, I saw him backstage. He has a brand new look, as you can see. but this is not the same Luke Gallows that we knew before. I mean, Festus, who was formerly known as Festus, was just a you know, I mean, we all remember Festus was, but Luke Gallows, with the help of CM Punk over the break between first and second season of WEDF, just transformation like I've never seen before. This guy is insane.
It all started, however, when Luke Gallows pledged allegiance to the Straight Edge Society and helped Punk counter the 420 Society, who ultimately, I don't know, I guess gave Punk some kind of drive to put an end to the 420 Society once and for all at WEDF Royal Reckoning.
That's right, but this, I mean, I'm telling you, this Luke Gallows that you see will make, he will excite you. I've seen him practicing, you know, I mean, I see a lot of stuff that you don't see backstage. This guy,
we see a lot of stuff you don't see backstage.
Well, no, but I mean, we see a lot, but I get some more backstage interviews and stuff than you get. No, just trust me. You don't want to know where I've been.
I know where you've been.
That's because your mom doesn't know how to shut up.
No, I just know where you've been. Because we're great, remember?
That's true. But anyway, this match is going on right now, and McIntyre, whoa.
Missile drop kick from McIntyre.
Luke Gallows was trying. It seems that both of these men are a little rusty. This is a great opportunity to...
I think with the fact that this is both of these men's first matches in a way, Luke Gallows is a single star. Drew McIntyre in his debut in WEDF, the pressure is definitely on for both of these men to make an impact here tonight.
What you have to remember is you have to keep your calm no matter how nervous inside you may be. Do not let it show on the outside, because if you let your opponent know the fear that you have in your eyes, then he will use that to his advantage.
And the one who can take advantage of that shows signs of a world champion in the making.
Both of these men trying to take it. Looks like Drew McIntyre is trying to find some momentum.
McIntyre is trying to do everything he can against the powerhouse in Luke Gallows. Gallows falls face first down after the drop kick from McIntyre. Ooh!
Wow, what a hard chop. That's hard knife edge. That's something you expect to see from a guy like him.
Oh, wait a minute. McIntyre. Oh, very nice.
Wow. What a gut buster. Very innovative move.
Both the knees and... Oh! A flatliner, I believe that was. And I think Drew McIntyre is going to set him up right here, ladies and gentlemen. This is the Future Shock DDT.
Very devastating move. And this has to be the end for Luke Gallows. Here's the cover.
One.
Oh, there's
a fast count.
Well, the ref seems to be confused, but McIntyre is awarded the victory. Rightfully so, as we look at the replay. That vicious gut buster, very innovative maneuver, as I mentioned before.
Which led to this flatliner you see right here, and then ultimately led to the end of Luke Gallows with this very nicely executed Future Shock DDT to give Drew McIntyre his first win on the WEDF roster.
McIntyre showing how devastating he can be. He may not be the biggest or the strongest, but man, he knows when to capitalize. He is such a... I mean, he makes a wrestling match into a chess match. Very brilliant in the way that he won that match.
There is a reason why they call this man the Chosen One. He might have proven that here tonight. Regardless, ladies and gentlemen, we will be right back. We're going to take a commercial break. We're going to talk a little bit about some stuff and shiz.
Fuck,
stay tuned for Smack.
Daniel Bryan. Okay, recording and whatnot.
All right. Restart 5, 4. Platinum Age is great. Go.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. right now, coming to the ring is Alberto Del Rio, one of the new superstars here in WEDF.
Del Rio
impact last Raw by injuring, or I guess further injuring, Rey Mysterio.
That's correct. Further injuring Rey Mysterio is the correct term. Reason being for that, ladies and gentlemen, Rey Mysterio revealed on Raw that after his grueling triple threat match involving Matt Hardy and Edge for the World Heavyweight Championship, his kneecap had been broken from a chair shot that Edge had done to his knee, and Alberto Del Rio went on to further injure Rey Mysterio with that rolling cross arm breaker. It's unclear whether or not if Rey Mysterio will be back anytime soon, but all we know is that Alberto Del Rio is here, and the man, he exudes perfection.
This guy is the equivalent of, actually, I think he's a descendant of Mexican royalty.
That is correct. Bloodline of kings. Natural-born millionaire.
You can see Tony Chimmel being forced to let him in, not let him speak. There he is. I mean, that's what he believes in. Wait a minute. Chavo Guerrero coming to the ring. What he has to say to Del Rio.
Are you serious right now?
Well, what?
I don't know why Chavo is out here, to be honest.
Well, no, that's what I'm telling you. I don't know what he's doing out here, what he has to say. But we're gonna find out right now.
And by saying I don't know why, I just mean I don't care. Get him the fuck off my television. Eddie is a million times better than this overrated piece of shit.
He should
go back to being Jack Swagger, Soaring Eagle, and getting the fuck out of my ring.
Come on, Chavo Guerrero is part of a legendary wrestling family, and...
And does anybody care about him? Does anybody care?
I do. And Del Rio, he feels disrespected by Del Rio, and, well, that doesn't stop Del Rio from attacking him.
Hey, you hate Daniel Bryan, I hate Chavo Guerrero. I just don't see anything in the guy. I'm sorry. I don't see anything in Chavo Guerrero, just like you don't see anything in Daniel Bryan.
I mean, it's not like I love the guy. I see your point, definitely, and I think that Del Rio making an impact at the cost of Chavo Guerrero is something that, you know, can really help the guy.
He's lucky he didn't get rolling cross armbreaker right now. He's not worth it. He's definitely not worth it. But I would much rather have him lock it in and break his arm for good.
What Del Rio said was that he was going to take his time with Chavo. This is definitely not over between the two. But right now, we are on to the exciting main event for the evening. Fatal 4-Way Battle Royal between Goldberg, Danny Jackpot, Kurt Angle, John Cena. The winner will be the number one contender for Christian's World Heavyweight Championship.
First off, we see Danny Jackpot coming out, one of the new draftees coming over from Raw to SmackDown. The reason Danny Jackpot is on SmackDown to begin with is none other than Kurt Angle winning a draft match against none other than Kofi Kingston. And well, we gotta say it's a bad taste of karma for Kurt Angle, because now not only is Kurt on the same brand with Danny, Danny is back in the world title hunt with him.
That's right. You know, Kurt Angle's one goal during WrestleMania and at WrestleMania was to end this streak of Danny Jackpot and to just remove him from everything that was associated with Kurt Angle. And when he won that match, unfortunately for Kurt Angle, that allowed Danny Jackpot to not just come to SmackDown with him, but to be inserted into the world title picture. I mean, he's just as capable of winning this match as anybody else. He's a former WEDF champion. He is a multiple-time world champion. He is one of the most decorated superstars out of all of the competitors in the ring tonight. And so he has just as much of a chance as anybody else to win this match.
Danny Jackpot is also one of the men closest to completing the prestigious WEDF Grand Slam Championship. But there you see the man who beat Danny Jackpot at WrestleMania in a submission match, Kurt Angle. Now, I got to say, I don't know anybody who will defend Kurt Angle at this point, but I got to say, what this man has done to get himself back in the world title picture, taking out a man who he believes has robbed him of all of his glory, beating him on the biggest stage of them all in his own signature match, and getting back in the world title picture just like that. Look, you have to give Kurt Angle credit for that.
I definitely give Kurt Angle credit, because when it comes to getting what you want, you have to do what you have to do. For Kurt Angle, that was aligning himself with the boss, Vince McMahon. For us, that was aligning ourselves with Vicky Guerrero and coming here to SmackDown, you know? You have to do what you have to do, regardless of who you step on. It's either do that or be stepped on.
Not in any case, they're going to have... Well, everybody in here is going to have a big test against a man like Goldberg. Again, I've mentioned this time and time again. Goldberg is a man who has went almost 200 matches undefeated in WCW. This man is definitely a war machine of his own creation. There is barely anyone who can match up to the intensity, the power, the tenacity that Goldberg brings to the table in the WEDF.
Goldberg is that perfect example of just pure size, as you mentioned. And, you know, the question is he going to keep his, you know, is he going to be able to keep his mind focused on winning this entire match and not just on John Cena, who he claims is next? I mean, maybe when Goldberg says you're next, you know, that's not a good place to be. But right now, Goldberg can't just worry about John Cena. He has to worry about all three of his competitors tonight so that he may, you know, if he can get his chance to go and compete for that World Heavyweight Championship.
This is elimination rules applying as well, so we will find out for sure who will go on to face Christian without a shadow of a doubt.
That's right. You have to eliminate. You have to make sure that all three of the people you face get eliminated in some way, shape, or form, while at the same time keeping yourself in this match. And right now, here comes the man who was inches away from becoming the WEDF champion again, bringing it to SmackDown. If it weren't for Goldberg, you know, here comes John Cena.
John Cena, the former WEDF champion. I believe he's the only two-time WEDF champion at that. And I got to say, despite what you may think about John Cena, there is one thing you cannot deny about John Cena, and it is that John Cena is one of the hardest workers in WEDF and in professional wrestling today.
Look, his t-shirt said it all. It said, never give up. And that has been his mentality since the day that he walked in, since he began training for professional wrestling. And that mentality has worked for him to this point. And I don't see any reason why it wouldn't tonight.
His motto is to never back down and never quit. Give it 100% all you got into a match. Cena lives and dies by that
Cena
motto.
Going for a quick pin on Goldberg.
Interesting thing I see right here just from the first look of this match. Cena and Goldberg, Angle and Jackpot, all of these men are together fighting in their own heated rivalries together. It's in a big melting pot getting mixed up right here tonight in this four-way match.
Look, in this match, there are no friends. No matter what you think, you have to be in this match for yourself only. Because if you think for 1 second that somebody has your back, that could be the moment that you...
Wait a minute, lose. Danny Jackpot with a cash out on John Cena.
Oh, this could be the end.
One, two,
no. He kicks out. Kurt Angle working on Goldberg.
Angle and Goldberg, all four of these men, I've got to say, all four of these men deserve to be the world champion in WEDF. All four of these men will provide an interesting challenge for Christian, but only one of these men will get the honor. Who will go on to face Christian next week for the World Heavyweight Championship, ladies and gentlemen? you better stay tuned and you better find out who it is after this commercial break. Also, fuck Chavo Guerrero.
And fuck Daniel Bryan.
Yeah, give me a second.
All right.
This matchup continues our epic main event to determine the number one contender for Christian's World Heavyweight Championship.
Right, yes, that's right. Right now we have four competitors all competing for the right to once again hold gold. All four of these men are former world champions in their own right. And right now it's anybody's game. There is not one clear chance in John Cena with that bulldog on to whatever the fuck it's called on. Sorry, I'm a little rusty right now, but wait, what is this? Oh.
Snapshot style maneuver from Cena and Jackpot, but one question I gotta ask, who are you personally rooting for, Homer?
You know what? I gotta give it to John Cena right now. I think that the way that he lost on Raw gives him the momentum. I know that a loss usually brings the momentum off, but I think that he's going to prove himself against Goldberg and ultimately become the number one contender.
I would have to go, I just in a personal interest of who I would want to win more than anything, let's look at it like this. Danny Jackpot, Kurt Angle, and John Cena are all former WEDF World Champions. Goldberg has never really had a chance to compete for a WEDF World Championship. And I gotta say, this season may be his time to get that rightful shot and maybe even get another World Championship reign out of it.
Speaking of Goldberg, John Cena.
I may be speaking too soon. Cena just said, you can't see me. And here comes the five-knuckle shuffle.
This could be the end for Goldberg.
Danny Jackpot. Here we go.
Setting up for the double A.
Double A attitude adjustment. There it is.
Goldberg
no-sold it.
Cena quick with that shoulder block. Question is he going to avoid anything?
There's that spin out power bomb from John Cena signature. Now, yep. Wait a minute, Danny Jackpot with a senton.
Now, Danny Jackpot with that cover on
Hurricanrana, cover an angle. Two.
A two count. Kurt Angle almost eliminated from this match.
Oh, wait a minute, here we go. John Cena. Getting right underway, going to the top rope. Signature top rope leg drop. This is not looking good for Goldberg at all. But wait a minute, Cena's going to try to get Jackpot eliminated.
Jackpot tried to get involved. This could be the mistake that could cost him this match. No. Cena, his emotions may be getting to him. He went right back to Goldberg instead of trying to capitalize with the pin on Jackpot.
Is the main thing you wanted to cover for at least 10 seconds. Cena was the only man up and moving out of all four of these men.
But even then, when a person's only getting eliminated, you're not going to break up that pin. This is an elimination match.
Is every man for himself. Why would you break up pins?
Cena, instead of thinking about the big picture about this,
Wait a minute, here we go. STF on Goldberg. This could be a big...
Goldberg is the first eliminated.
This has got to send a huge wake-up call to Goldberg. Goldberg said Cena was next, and Cena just made him tap out right in the middle of the ring.
Cena virtually said, no, you.
Literally.
And allowed him to get him eliminated in this match, and now we're down to three competitors. But Cena continuing to impress. Has both
Cena
in the
stacking
corner.
Angle and Jackpot up in that big splash on both men.
I mean, Cena is continuing to. Oh, and there's a DDT. Not slowing down for a minute. There's a cover on Angle.
One, two.
Angle kicks out. But all three of these competitors trying to wait. Oh! Angle with that
assistant Enziguri from Cena and Jackpot. Very nice combination. Very wise strategy in a match like this.
But I'll say that Cena, immediately after getting that giving that assist to Jackpot, went right at him.
Cena is a one-man army. There is no denying that. He's got both Angle and Jackpot right where he wants them.
I mean, this is just insane for one man to completely decimate these three men.
Wait a minute. Oh. Hold on.
Going to be setting up the double A again.
Attitude yes, he is. Double A. But wait a minute. Kurt Angle.
Oh.
Triple.
German suplex.
Sure. I think we all know what agenda we're going with here. Two, three.
Angle wanted the final blow, but Cena got the pinfall. He's now eliminated both men, and it is now down to two. One of these two will face Christian for the World Heavyweight Championship on the next episode of SmackDown. The question is, will Cena continue this wave of momentum, or will Kurt Angle find an opening and become the number one contender?
I gotta say, between these two men, I would much rather see Kurt Angle. And the reason I say that, no disrespect to John Cena. I think Cena is a great competitor. I just think after everything Kurt Angle has gone through to get himself this world title match, just to try to get in a world title match, I don't think he's going to blow it here tonight. And I think he'll be Christian's best opponent.
Look, I have no personal interest in either of these competitors, but I will say that Angle, well, he appeared to have the momentum, but Cena.
Wait a minute,
again,
Cena now.
Roll.
Five knuckle shuffle.
Boom, connects.
And Cena flaunting a little
just
bit.
A world of trouble.
Cena, Angle fighting back against Cena. I think Cena was going to go for that AA, but Angle quickly fighting back against Cena before he can get the chance to go for it.
Oh, and Cena attacking the knee Angle attacking the knee of Cena. There's a headbutt.
Very nice strategy for Angle to do that. Maybe getting close to sinking in that ankle lock.
What's interesting is that Angle perhaps now using up the energy that he preserved in the early parts of this match where Cena just let it all out. The question is, will Cena have enough to defeat Angle, or will Angle's strategy prove to be helpful?
A better question is just exactly how much more does Cena have left in the tank?
I mean, we know that Cena's mentality is to never give up, so that's not really something.
Wait a minute. This could be the beginning of the end. Kurt Angle. One amigo. Two amigo. Three German amigos. I literally said it like that.
Yeah.
Three German suplexes.
That's all right.
Sue me.
Now, oh, here it comes.
The Angle slam.
I was going for the cover. This could be the end. This has to be the end.
One, two, three.
There it is. Angle becoming the number one contender using his strategy and his brain is definitely an asset. You can see Cena just putting it all out there. But in the end, where Cena lost, Cena essentially had no energy left, had no choice but to give up.
Couldn't put his shoulder up. John Cena has a lot of heart and determination. No question about that. Angle slam you see right there, topping off the match. And I got to tell you, Dolph Ziggler, RVD, and Jeff Hardy for the Intercontinental Championship. Christian and Kurt Angle for the World Championship. This next SmackDown is already looking to be stacked.
Not to mention, Platinum Age smirk.
Platinum Age, indeed.
Angle celebrating his very big, this is a huge victory for him.
Wait a minute! Hold on! This is the world champion, Christian. He's coming out. I think they're going to have a little face-to-face confrontation. Christian, now knowing who his opponent is, has to set his sights firmly on next week when he has to defend the World Heavyweight Championship for the first time against a tough, tough challenge in the wrestling machine.
Well, there's no doubt that Christian was backstage watching this match, carefully dissecting it and making sure that he knew exactly who he would face. And now that Kurt Angle is trying to celebrate this victory, Christian wants to let him know that this celebration is not going to last long. And then next week, he will retain the World Heavyweight Championship. The question is Christian right?
We will find out whether or not the Instant Classic is right. And in any case, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be a great technical battle, a great test for Christian, a great test for Angle, a great test to see whose will to be the world champion is greater.
And it's all the time.
This is all the time we have. Get ready for the next SmackDown coming to you whenever. This is the Platinum Age. Christian and Kurt Angle on the next SmackDown. We will see you later. Fuck Chavo Guerrero. Fuck Daniel Bryan.